Thank you for coming to answer our Fox 4 questions. Could you please say your name and your intention?
Sure, I'm Joshua Svaty. I'm running for governor of the state of Kansas.
Okay, thank you. Now, the first question is about education in Kansas. Lawmakers in the state have been wrangling over how to properly fund education. What will you do to lead on this issue?
First of all, we have to have an educational formula that's fair for the entire state. And that's going to be similar to the 92 school finance formula. There are some districts that have more money and some districts that have less money, and it's never going to be perfect. But we have to get it as close as possible. We know we've been underfunding K through 12 education. And we know what the legislature did last year was a pretty good first step. But it's also about balancing the needs of all of the other state agencies. And that's my task as governor, to balance what's needed in K through 12 to make sure that we have young people that want to enter the teaching profession, and then much younger people succeeding in that portion of our state's budget. But also making sure that it's not to the detriment of every other state agency.
Okay, thank you. The second question is about social services in Kansas. Social services in the state have seen deep cuts after the Brownback era tax cuts, from mental health to services for the aging. The tax cuts have been reversed, so how can you reassure Kansans that the economy is on the right track?
So, unfortunately, almost everything has seen deep cuts over the last 8 years, and Kansans generally see that and feel it first in public education. But unfortunately, now they're seeing it in almost every element of where their lives touch state government. And that's been most apparent, I think, around social services, particularly the Department of Children and Families. We are losing children, some cases, to the point of very, very sad stories of death. And that is simply something that the state should not have. We cannot abide that. And it is incumbent upon us as lawmakers to make sure that everyone in the state knows that we treat the most vulnerable among us as the most important. And so, you know, similar to as I talked about K through 12, when you talk about social services, it's going to take us a while to get back, but we have to have the appropriate people in those offices, the appropriate administrator running the agency, making sure each and every day that no child gets lost in the system. And a lot of that is simply the money, investing the money to make it happen, but also having an administration that cares enough to stay on it to make sure that it happens.
What will you be able to do to promote job growth in the state?
So there are a lot of things we can be doing to increase job growth in the state of Kansas. One, we actually have a lot of areas of the state that are looking for workers. We have a workforce problem, and the state needs to be focused on the appropriate workforce development, and that's making sure that our higher education institutions and even our high schools are plugged in with what business needs when those young people enter the workforce. But then to make sure that the state continues growing, I think the last 8 years have shown us that all of the tax policy in the world and all of the incentives the state provides cannot fix the problem of perception. And I think that Kansas has a perception problem right now, that we are going downhill or we're going backward, both within and among Kansans and then outside of the state. And there are a number of things that we can do to change people's sense of where the state is headed, because we know that millennials are not moving to communities because they found a job there. They move to the community they like, and then they find work. And so if we are not the state or the community that millennials want to move to, we're going to continue to struggle to attract them, and we're going to continue to struggle to attract the businesses that are looking for those communities that have a lot of activity among young people. And so I think that my candidacy in some respects represents the future of the state of Kansas, and there are things that we can do on day one, such as reinstating civil protections for LGBT employees in state government that sends an immediate message that the open state, the reasonable state, the well-governed state that we've been through most of our history is back.
Okay, thank you. Fourth and final question. What's going right in Kansas, and how can you make it better as governor?
Absolutely, and I'm glad that you're asking that. You know, so many times people, particularly Democrats, talk about how bad everything is. As I have toured the state, and of course I've grown up here, and I'm a fifth generation member of this state, and have proud and deep roots here, I see great things happening all the time. I see the Kansas Can redesign going on in our schools, thinking about what the classroom of the future is going to look like. I also see economic development happening in rural communities, usually associated with the industry that's around there, largely agriculture or oil and gas. And I think it's important for the state to think about how can we find those successes and make sure that if the state is investing in economic development or job growth, that we are looking at what's working in the state and try to replicate that, because there are some communities around the state, some communities in fact that are extraordinarily small, that are seeing success right now because of businesses that are growing there. There's also great things happening in the Kansas City metropolitan area. There's a moment here in Kansas City, and I think everyone can sense it. And it's happening on the Missouri side, but it's also happening on the Kansas side. And we just have to make sure that every community in the metropolitan area, you know, from southern Johnson County all the way to eastern Wyandotte County, KCK, the Quindaro neighborhoods, they are seeing that same investment. They're seeing the same cranes with new buildings and new opportunities and new jobs happening, because this is an exciting time for Kansas, but we need an administration that can reflect the excitement that's happening statewide.
Okay, thank you so much for answering our Fox 4 questions.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Yep.